Alright, I'm going to keep this hand. It's got turn 1 Mental Misstep and turn 2 Standstill on the Plague. I get to play turn 1 Creeping Tar Pit. Turn 2, I could probably just go Underground Sea Standstill. I don't actually need to play the Mishra's Factory. Like, my opponent gets the idea. And my goal is not to attack immediately. I could also cast Demonic Tutor on turn 2 if I really wanted to, but that will highly depend on what I'm playing against. Mox Pearl does not offer me a ton of info. Could be a Mentor deck. Oh, it looks like the Oath Mirror. All right. Oath Mirror is interesting. I don't unfortunately have a Forbidden Orchard, so I might lose very quickly here. Let's see what I draw. Yeah, if I need to basically draw Forbidden Orchard or a Mox, because a Mox I can Demonic Tutor for Orchard here. Well, a little late on the Force of Will. Probably just dead here, since my opponent's going to Oath. I'm going to at least see the Oath of Druids, but I think I'm just basically dead. So let's just attack for one and pass. Got turn one killed. The Oath Mirror is actually really dumb. I'm not a fan of the Oath Mirror, but that's fine. Let's see. So my opponent's going to Oath. I unfortunately cannot stop them. See what sort of info I get. Oh, looks like a more show and tell oath list. With repeal, I like that. An academy, so higher concentration of artifacts. And then, yeah, like I said, main, at least one main deck show and tell, the Imperial Tutor, Puritan. This is a more standard oath list. Alright. Well, I think that'll about do it. I'm not gonna force my opponent to go through it here. So, sideboarding in the Oath Mirror, there's actually not a ton you can do here either. Not having anything but Jason creature lands makes it a little tougher, but I like the Treasure Cruise. I don't mind a Nature's Claim, but I think Abrupt Decay might be better. Niles Bellbone's Forest, let's see. I actually like Standstill here. I don't like Memory's Journey as much. Maybe I just leave one Oath into Tutor for. For the most part, Oath is not that interesting. Crystal Brand I actually want because my opponent might have Show and Tell, and or likely does, and you can actually hard cast it. That's not completely irrelevant. I mean, the mirror is pretty ridiculous. Maybe I don't actually need the forest. That's probably unnecessary. All right, guess I'm good. All right, well, I'd like to play first. Let's try that again. Yeah, this hand works. Play turn one Misty Rainforest, go. Turn two, I can play a Standstill. See if my opponent has turn on Oath again. My opponent mulliganed to 6, so mulligan to 5. It's possible if I don't play a Forbidden Orchard this game, my opponent could very easily not know I'm playing Oath. Maybe I should just side out the Gristlebrands entirely, but again, I think because Show and Tell is a real thing, I would rather keep the Gristlebrands. If my opponent Show and Tells in and we both get Gristlebrands, I assume that's slightly better for the person who gets to untap first, which is me, because I can attack and I can try to find a Jace. No plays on turn one. Actually don't mind drawing land, so I'm just going to wait. Oh, if my opponent's a one drop, I'll be happy to Mental Misstep it. I could cast Time Walk, but I don't think I want to do that on my turn two. I mean, we'll see what I draw, but I'm not as interested. Imperial Seal. All right. Actually, don't mind Imperial Seal. It's just down one card. It's a Sorcery Speed Vampiric Tutor. And with double Force of Will in hand, I feel like I can handle almost anything that comes my way. Let's draw. Let's get an Underground Sea. And I don't care if my opponent knows I have Tropical Island in my deck. Now, play a Standstill. See if my opponent goes Orchard Oath, and then I Force of Will it. And I look a lot like just a Bugstill deck, especially once I boarded out almost all my Oaths. Alright, well, if my opponent has Oath, they probably just want to cast it. They do. Alright, Standstill happens. Draw 3 cards. I'm going to Force of Will, pitching Mental Misstep. I could Abrupt Decay, but I feel like I'm going to get a chance to do that later. If my opponent forces back, I probably will Abrupt Decay rather than use a second force. And I would want to be able to cast Standstill on my turn, but... Alright, opponent's on one card. What do they even pitch? Flusterstorm, sure. I could also Time Walk. Ooh, drawing a land would be kind of nice here. I'm still just gonna time walk here because if I hit a land, then I can abrupt decay the oath, attack, and then cast a standstill post combat. All right, let's draw land. Just get another underground sea here, I think. Abrupt decay oath. Nope. Let's not tap all of those cards for black. That would be a disaster. Cast another standstill. And I've got the token, so my opponent's going to have to break standstill regardless here. And the great part about this is, you know, it got crushed so fast game one that my opponent doesn't know that I'm playing Oath, so my opponent is not going to sideboard any Oaths or anything like that, and I just have four Forbidden Orchards in my deck that do a good job of countering it. Also, I've just drawn all standstills and Force of Wills this game, which is pretty great against an opponent who mulled to five and then cast Imperial Seal. So I don't know how many cards down that puts my opponent when they Imperial Seal for something after mulling to five and then break a standstill, though I guess I had a pitch to force, but so did they. So yeah, I can't count how many cards that is, but it's a lot. All right, strip mine. Yeah, I mean, I'll play it. I don't even know if I want to use it here. It doesn't seem like it accomplishes much. I already have a spirit in play, so strip mining Forbidden Orchard isn't all that helpful. Could strip mine like Underground Sea, but there's not that many spells my opponent could cast that they can't cast with just like Flooded Strand Forbidden Orchard, so just wait. Maybe my opponent draw like a library or something. Definitely don't want to play that one. Really, part of my sub goal here is to counter any, you know, hand disrupts or anything like that, so I can preserve the illusion that I'm just a bug still deck. Which, I mean, who knows? Maybe my opponent just like already guessed I'm playing Oath or whatever. But I think that if I can do that, it would be a useful thing to do. All right. Well, I probably shouldn't cast Thoughtseize into my own standstill, is my guess. Let's just keep hitting for one. And, well, I mean, eventually, I can start discarding Thought Seizes or whatever, that's fine. Actually, my opponent's gonna have to play something, right? Or I'll draw Mishra's Factory or Creeping Tar Pit and win the game very quickly. Alright, well, I'm not gonna play Nile Spell on either. Getcha. Opponent goes to 9 here. I wanna manage it out of Gristlebrand, that's what I really wanna do. That would be great. I'm going to have to discard first unless I draw a land. So my best draw here is Creeping Tar Pit. Not Jace. All right, time to discard. I think I discard Thoughtseize because, again, I don't want to discard... Actually, I'll discard Nile Spellbomb. Nile Spellbomb doesn't seem particularly relevant here. And it doesn't give my opponent a ton of info that I have a Nile Spellbomb in my sideboard either. The funny thing about the standstill is until I drew Jace, there was not a whole lot I could play that would be relevant here. Alright, well, Gristlebrand is another card I don't want to show my opponent. So I think I discard Thoughtseize here. Let's see, opponent goes to 7, yeah. And then next turn maybe discard Jace. I don't really want to discard Jace though. Wouldn't mind my opponent breaking the standstill though. Ooh, my opponent's thinking. It's time to ponder. Why don't we cast actual Ponder? Though that also could be happening. All right, Mox Sapphire breaks standstill. I'm gonna draw up to a million cards, including, I was gonna draw Mishra's Factory next turn, so my opponent timed this well. And if my opponent plays another artifact, I guess I could strip mine Academy at that point. I mean, I could have done it in response to the Mox Sapphire, but don't know if that's necessary. Let's see, so what is my opponent going to play with 4 cards in hand? I mean, they're not beating this counter wall unless they play something very strange, given that I've got Force, Misstep, Flusterstorm. Mox Sapphire Go? Interesting. Would not have predicted that. Let's play Mishra's Factory. Let's play my own Mox Sapphire. Let's attack. My opponent to 5. I could play Jace. I think I just play Treasure Cruise. Yeah, that seems fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. And if my opponent counters it, that's fine too. All right, they don't, so I'm going to have to discard a bunch of cards. I'm not casting Ancestral here. All right, let's see. So I want to keep... Yeah, I think I still want to keep this Gristlebrand and this Orchard in my hand, which is kind of funny, but I do think it's worth it. I probably don't need this Jace either. All right. And I'll keep Ancestral because Ancestral should be able to find me more stuff. It's possible I shouldn't have Treasure Cruised because I drew a second Orchard and then I didn't want to discard any of them. But we'll see how this ends up turning out. Repeal, targeting the Mox. Okay, is my opponent going to Tendrils me out or something? What's going on here? Actually going to strip mine Academy in response to Mox now. I just realized that I don't really need the extra mana. And this reduces my opponent's total mana. Especially if my opponent's going to play a second Mox this turn. Mox Sapphire resolves. Mox Ruby resolves. See, look at that. Great use of strip mine. Maybe I should have just done that earlier, but hey, things worked out. Thoughtseize. I don't like Thoughtseize. Let's Ancestral Recall myself. If my opponent casts Flusterstorm here, then I should be able to fluster for a bunch. I'm getting a little greedy here, not keeping all those orchards and whatnot in hand, but look, I like sub-games, and this seems sweet. All right, Mental Misstep. So I can Flusterstorm for 6. Opponent's on 2 cards. Let's try and force the Mental Misstep. I'm trying to set up a Flusterstorm where I can counter both my opponent's spells, because if they counter back or something along those lines. All right. Let's just fluster that for a bunch. All right, that happens. Opponent's on 2 cards. And I get to brainstorm if something bad happens. All right, fluster, go away. We're done with you. Opponent's on 5. I'm attacking for 3 potentially. All right, untap, draw another standstill. Let's cast brainstorm. All right, let's put back Orchard. I guess I can't put back Gristlebrand also. Let's play a land. Animate Mishra's Factory. Attack my opponent to 2 here. And then I think I cast Standstill because it leaves Mana Drain up still. And Mental Misstep. And then I get to get 3 new cards after sacrificing Pluto Delta, which seems pretty good. Also, Oath does not save my opponent here. There aren't a ton of cards my opponent could have in their deck that would actually save them. They'd have to have, like, Show and... I mean, now they play the land, it's impossible. They could have had, like, Show and Tell, Gristlebrand, Flusterstorm, maybe. Was this hardcast Gristlebrand? Nice, I like it. It's very stylish. All right, let's sac Pluto Delta in response. My opponent's last card. I don't know, there's a 0 mana counter spell. They could have a Thwart. Alright, let's sac Pluto Delta. I guess just get Tropical as my actual last target. Alright. That happens. That's Mana Drain Gristlebrand. Actually, again, I'm just going to Force of Will Gristlebrand pitching. Mental Misstep. No reason to show my opponent that I have Mana Drain because I haven't actually cast that yet. Look, when you're winning by a lot, you can do a lot of weird things, which I am doing. All right, going to game 3. Still have a Gristlebrand in my deck. Also, I want to be able to Oath it up if my opponent plays Oath and I go strip mine your Orchard and start using Orchard. Don't want Memory's Journey, don't want Toxic Deluge. Still don't want Nature's Claim. I think Abrupt Decay is actually enough. Could play Pernicious Deed. My opponent does have kind of a, like, maybe has, like, Time Vault also. Maybe I just don't want any Oaths in my deck, given that my opponent is going to have them, but I guess I could tutor it up. I could take out a Nihil Spellbomb for a Nature's Claim, maybe. Alright, let's try that. Alright, on the draw. Yeah, I'm going to keep this hand. I don't really want Gristlebrand in my hand here, but I have Mental Misstep plus Flusterstorm to protect me. Yes, if my opponent plays a turn 1 or 2 Oath, I could be in trouble. Put a mulligan to 6 here. But I don't think I can mulligan a hand that loses to a turn 1 Oath with Orchard. Put a mulligan to 5 here. This is the kind of hand where I would Mental Misstep an Imperial Seal. Because then I would not be able to stop Oath on turn 2. I'm gonna Force of Will helps a lot. All right, let's just play Misty and pass the turn. I'm gonna keep up mana. I don't think I need to play the Nile Spellbomb because I want to keep up Flusterstorm. I think if my opponent goes Oath with Force of Will back up, I'll really want to be able to force the Oath and then Flusterstorm the Force of Will. Because if I can't. That does not work with Mental Misstep. Preordain. I'm gonna Mental Misstep that. Opponent mold to 5. Countering Preordains is usually a pretty good business. All right, now I will probably just play Standstill. And actually, I'm just gonna play Nile Spellbomb. I think that's better. I just realized that by waiting a turn, I have Flusterstorm plus Force of Will up, even though I have to maybe pitch the Standstill. And this also lets me get the Spellbomb into play, which is one less card off the discard if we start going to that. Opponent can't cast Oath this turn, which is nice. I'm just going to cycle this Spellbomb. Sacrifice Spellbomb. Pay a mana. Alright, I just kind of want a blue card to pitch to Force of Will here. Oh, well, let's just go with Thoughtseize. That's actually a pretty good place to start. Demonic Tutor, Dig Through Time, 2 lands. Alright, well, I'll take Demonic Tutor, or 2 Moxes. Not playing Moxes into a deck with Standstill is kind of risky. Actually, I don't even know if I'm supposed to play Standstill. I kind of think I'm not, because my opponent can't cast Dig. They can't cast Oath. They don't even have green mana. And if I draw a land, I can just cast Jace, which is much, much better than casting Standstill. So if I play Standstill, I think it actually helps my opponent more, because, yes, they'll eventually break it, but I'm just doing nothing for many turns if I do that. Whereas my opponent might be forced to do nothing for many turns just by the contents of their hand. I mean, they just don't have a playable hand here. So, now they drew an Academy. And some Moxen. They're still not quite at Dig Through Time. They're 1 mana short. All right, and I drew a land. That is convenient. Got a black, play Jace. And I'm just gonna plus on my opponent. My hand is pretty great. I'll let my opponent draw Mox. They're gonna cast Dig Through Time, and I'm gonna Force of Will pitching Flusterstorm because my opponent's got so much mana. And I think that'll be fine. I mean, they should cast Dig Through Time here. Leaving like 2 mana up, probably. Probably wanna leave up. Leaving 1 mana up. Actually, they could leave 0 mana up if they don't exile the Demonic Tutor, but probably leaving a mana up to cast Thoughtseize is decent. All right, well, let's see. Either way, let's counter Dig Through Time. Opponents on no cards. And now it actually doesn't matter too much if they know I'm playing Oath. Ooh. Mana Drain is nice. Phew, that's game. All right, let's put back Gristlebrand and Oath. Play Sensei's Divine Top. Play Creeping Tar Pit. And I'll just pass the turn now, leaving Mana Drain up for, and then next turn I can play Standstill, perhaps. See what my opponent does, of course. Alright. Spin the top end of turn, since there's no reason not to. Let's draw Gristlebrand though. I'm probably just gonna be brainstorming with Jace here anyway. I could not worry about the Standstill. The reason I don't want to do that. Let's see. I'm trying to think what's the problem with me going Orchard Oath. So if I play Orchard Oath, my opponent then untaps and draws Orchard and plays Orchard, and they have to make a token immediately, and then I untap and I bounce their token with Jace, make a second token, and then even if they draw an Orchard, that still doesn't work. All right, that actually seems fine here. And I have a blue card on top of my library to draw if I need to use it for Force of Will. And I'll pass the turn. All right. Things are looking pretty good. I think I got this one. I mean, my opponent's got 2 cards in hand now. This is vintage. There are combinations of 2 cards that are pretty good here, but given the fact that I have Mana Drain plus Force of Will, it seems highly unlikely that they're going to be able to get through those 2 cards and mount any sort of comeback. I really need to spin the top here. Because I'm going to hit Gristlebrand two cards down. And I'm just going to plus on my opponent. I think this reduces the number of outs they have reasonably well. We're both at one creature, so we're good. Because this way I can just counter the Preordain. Opponent's last card is Preordain. All right. It's forcible Preordain. I mean, I could have used Gristlebrand. I don't even think I need to. And opponent could attack, but it doesn't accomplish anything because I can block and then make a token just to make sure my opponent can't do it. I have to make sure I never end up with two creatures. Well, it's not going to work out great for you. All right, block. And then end of turn, let's spin top using Forbidden Orchard. And spinning top doesn't actually matter here. Oh, no, I guess it does. I'm not oathing, but I am going to draw seven cards at some point. So again, spinning top is kind of irrelevant. All right, let's go ahead and draw with Gristlebrand since I'm at a million. I mean, my opponent can't win this game. It's fun to play out, though. So now I even get to do stuff like strip mine your Flooded Strand. Oh, my opponent didn't even sack it, so I can then plus two Jace on you. Put a Ponder on the bottom. No, I'll put Ponder on top. The reason I'm leaving like cantrips on top is that I can just counter them. And I don't really, and that way I just know what my opponent's next turn is. I mean, it's unlikely they're, again, going to draw any card in Magic that can get around these things, but what if they have some weird combination of, like, they draw Caracas and into something? I don't even know. I'm not even sure what all this could happen here, but better safe than sorry. All right, plus two Jason, my opponent. Time Vault? No, you can have Time Vault. I'll probably even let that one resolve. I'm winning by so much here. Do I get extra points for winning by like millions? I have like the Standstill lock, the Jace lock, the Gristlebrand lock, the Creeping Tar Pit lock, you know, all the locks. And that should do it. I mean, I did take my opponent walking into five twice, but Oath is at its core, an inconsistent deck, which I'm playing Oath also, but you know, so that is one of the risks you take when you bring Oath of Druids into battle. Let's hit again. And opponent is dead. Sweet.